Schwarzer Knacker. Ich bin der Schwarzer Knacker.
Yeah. Well, I need only to be near a cork of a bottle, and I get the full benefit of it. But here I got a glass of something, pressed into my hand, and I sipped out of it and meandered until I came to the terrace where General Donovan, surrounded by junior officers, was trying to hit a target across from that terrace on a facing slope. And as he noticed me, he said, "Try your luck, soldier." Well, I always had poor eyesight, and I had already two sips of the drink, whatever it was, but order is order, so I clicked my heels, saluted, and said, "By your leave, sir," and grabbed that 45, aimed that 45 in the direction of the target. My goodness. To my great surprise and surprise of everybody else, the target responded. Then I quickly opened a 45 pistol, threw out the casing, turned it back, said thank you, made an about face, and marched off in a straight line, more or less. So this is how I met General Donovan, my one and only encounter. But since that day at the Algiers headquarters, I was known as a sharpshooter.
Yeah, you lose your name, your family will never know, you lose all your friends, you have nobody, and if you are arrested, we don't know you.
And then all sorts of people started in the neighborhood asking about me, my family, everybody, security clearance.
It was worth every minute of it, I think, and I hope that people realize how important the women were in the OSS effort. He got to talking and he found out that I had been studying Japanese and that I was a newspaper woman, and he said, "Well, would you like to work for the government?" And I said, "Well, yeah, but on one condition, that I want to go overseas because that's where I think all the action is." And he said, "I think I can guarantee that." And I said, "Well, then what would I do?" And he said, "I can't tell you until you sign up with us." And then that's how I got in. I was curious, but I did want to see some action. And that was what happened to me.
There was a sizable number of Czechs and Slovaks working as labor for the Germans. So we hit them with a leaflet called, inviting them to cross the lines. And for that, 600 guys that crossed the lines and deprived the German army of labor, I got my Bronze Star.
London was not a walk in the park. We had the V1s, V2s from 40s, and a few Dorniers, Junkers, the London docks were known as Buzz Bomb Alley, and it really wasn't fun. But I mean, we were all fatalists, and if your name's on it, so be it. If you survive, well, lucky you. The story was, if you heard a V2, chances are you'd survive. If you didn't, it didn't matter anyway, because you'd be gone. The V1s were nasty. They really were. very nasty. You all didn't have those, did you? No. But the king and queen would always go, the flag, the royal standard always flew on Buckingham Palace. They'd never left London, and they would go down to where the worst bombing had been in person. And, oh, what a morale builder. And so would Churchill. Believe you me, the war plans, I think I'm right in saying, the German war plans are America was next. The U-boats were all ready, and if that had happened, you'd all be speaking German on one coast and Japanese on the other, probably.